Hello, everybody. This is Scott Bradley coming to you from www.scottbradley.name. And in this video, I'm going to be covering the final four notes of the Today in Your Notebook. Again, if this is the first time that you're seeing a video from me, I highly recommend that you go back to the channel. All that you have to do is click Evernote Scott in the bottom left-hand corner under the YouTube video. Be sure to go watch part one, part two, and part three of this video series first, and then you can come back to this video and be able to consume the rest of the content. It's important that you go through the content from part one to part four in order, just because it's ordered in a specific way to make it make sense to you the best way possible. So as you already know, the Today in Your Notebook is pretty much the dashboard for your life. It helps you keep everything straight, helps you be more effective, helps you be able to reference certain things that are important throughout your everyday life. And in the past videos, we've gone over daily execution, waiting on, future opportunities, daily, weekly, monthly, quarterly, yearly, holding tank, yearly holidays and dates, current contractual obligations, budget, addresses to change, to do with time, cool free tools, products to consider, and products I want, and what that means and how it should be in your daily fill note vision board part of your notebook rather than in here. And finally, the last four notes that are in this Today in Your Notebook, which is the dashboard for your life, are want to do's, learning time, reading list, and books loan. This is going to be a very quick video. So let's get to it. So again, the want to do notes, that's going to also be on your vision board. So in the last video, in video three of this four-part series, I explained that the products that you want are going to be in your vision board, but even more so, your want to do's are also going to be in your vision board of your daily fill, and I'm just going to show you where that is. Daily fill, vision board is going to be right here. So aside from putting the products that you want here, you can also put like pictures of maps of where you want to go or the experiences that you want to have or whatever floats your boat when it comes to helping you be reminded of what it is you really want to do with your time, or want to do's, or, you know, I want to go to SeaWorld, I want to go to Disney World, I want to go to Europe, I want to go to Paris. You know, you can put the images of the places that you want to do with your time as much as you want the stuff in your life. And again, this just kind of is another way to keep track of the certain things in your life, because this is really the dashboard of your life, how you operate, etc. The next note is the learning time note. You know, if you're an entrepreneur or if you're an entrepreneurial person or if you always are committed to growth and growing yourself from the inside out and knowing that the better version that you become every single day, the better you can add value to other people and just enjoy your life and have a more enriching life. I'm really committed to that. It's like T. Harv Eker in his Secrets of the Millionaire Mind book says, you know, become a better version of yourself every single day. Focus on doing that. And a part of that is really adding stuff to you that's going to help you be better for others. So what I like to do is put learning time. You know, what do I want to learn? Specifically here, kind of one little unique fact about me is of all the classical instruments that make music, I actually know a little bit of piano, but I can't read music, so it's kind of an interesting conundrum that I deal with. But one of these items in my learning time is to learn how to play the violin. I basically, just to keep a long story short, I love the sound of the violin, I love the tone it has, I love the feeling and the emotion that it creates. And so, like, on one of the things on my learning time, it's, you know, learn how to play the violin. Another one could be learn a new language. What languages do I want to learn? Another thing could be learning another specific skill set, whether it's, you know, ballroom dancing or, you know, how to do XYZ thing with XYZ item, whatever it is. You know, this really allows you to dump, what do I want to learn? And again, you know, it gives you that opportunity in those spaces of your life where you have time. You know, I know we pretty much don't have much time, but in those spaces that you do have time, this really allows you to come reference this note to see, well, what do I want to learn? What do I have time to learn now that I haven't had time in the past? So again, it allows you to dump everything from your mind, not think about it, know it's in a place to reference in the future. That's really what this Today in Your Notebook is, because it drives your life as much as your daily fill notebook does as well. Next note in this is your reading list. And basically, it's broken down into two parts. There's the books to finish and the books to start. I don't know about you, but for me, I sometimes am reading 3 to 4 books at any given time. This really allows me to keep track of where I'm at with the books that I need to close and close the loop, and then also help me add books that I want to start. So if you're anything like me, you may have friends that recommend books to you all the time, or you are in your Facebook and you see people sharing news about new books. This really allows you to dump everything, so when you do have that open space to add a book to your life and finish it and read it and absorb it, this is a great place to reference. Now finally, the final note in this Today in Your Notebook, I feel like we've climbed a massive mountain here over these 4-part video series, are the books loaned. So I know most of us either probably have iPads or Nooks or a certain tablet that we use to read our books. But in the old days, those didn't exist. So, I have a pretty big library of books, and sometimes I do loan books to specific friends or family members to say, hey, you need to read this book, this is going to help you, so on and so forth. This final note really helps you keep track of who has your book and, what do you need to do to make sure to get back. So I typically put the book title and the person's name. So it could be Rich Dad Poor Dad and my brother Eric has the book. So I want to make sure that, again, I can drop it down. I don't have to think about, oh, how many books do I have loaned? Who has it? What? Keep me up at night worrying about, oh God, am I missing something? Again, this note really helps you have that peace of mind every single day. So that concludes the 4-part video series of the Today in Your Notebook. I really hope that you have gotten a lot of value out of this, and I would love to hear your thoughts. Please, in the comment section below, put what you liked best about this and what specifically stuck out to you that is going to add a ton of value to your life looking at all of these notes. Again, I always appreciate your thumbs up. Appreciate your shares to your network. And, again, if you haven't already done so, just wanted to remind you one more time, if you haven't signed up for updates, go to scottbradley.name/evernotetips, put your name and email in, and you'll get the email to confirm your subscription. You're only going to get updates from me when new videos hit the channel. I just did this because I didn't want to have to rely on YouTube, and I just wanted to be effective in getting the information to you that you definitely want to help you be the best you can in your life. So that concludes this video. I really hope that you've enjoyed this. I really hope that you have a great rest of your day and a wonderful rest of the week. And I have some more great content coming to you outside of this 4-part video series, so stay tuned. I look forward to it, and have a fantastic rest of the week. Bye for now.